What gets me most excited about reimagining carbon is not to just think of it as a pollutant, but we should also look for innovation and work on creating innovation that not only creates a value from carbon for products for traditional industries, but also grows the economy for future industries that use the carbon or carbon dioxide as a feedstock. My name is Saad Dara. I'm CEO of Mangrove Water Technologies.
Saad, Arman, and David are members of the Mangrove Water Technologies team, a team that is changing the way we used wastewater from industrial processes, with an idea that began in a humble research environment.
So we had this very neat idea a few years ago at UBC to couple removal of wastewater and carbon dioxide and generate value-added chemicals. And this was just an idea at that stage.
If you look at where it started in research, in a research comprehensive university, I think it really speaks to the point that we should not look at research as a cost, but as a strategic advantage for Canada.
Over the round one, round two, and round three grand challenge, we would have gone from a technology being demonstrated in a Tupperware container to a commercialized technology that's operating in the field and operating and demonstrating value with waste carbon dioxide and waste saline water.
Industrial processes often produce waste products, water or gas mixed up with toxic minerals and chemicals. What Mangrove does, in simplest terms, is convert that waste brine and waste carbon dioxide into valuable chemicals and desalinated water using an electrochemical cell. The technology has uses in countless industries, including Alberta's oil and gas sector.
We've been working primarily over the last couple of years with the oil and gas sector and have committed Canadian Natural to a field demonstration of a commercial module. But that same module and that box can go to other sectors as well. One of the areas that we've seen quite a bit of traction is within the lithium production sector. And why that's important is it allows us to play in not just the previous energy economy of the oil and gas, and fossil fuel-based, but also in the future economy, future energy economy of lithium-ion batteries and big electrification megatrend.
For 10 years, ERA has been accelerating the development of clean technology solutions that benefit Alberta and the world. In 2017, Mangrove received $3 million as part of Emissions Reduction Alberta's Grand Challenge. They were given 2 years to develop a path towards commercialization and a 1 megaton net GHG reduction in Alberta. And now, they've been awarded funding as part of the last phase of ERA's Grand Challenge.
For round three, ERA is going to be funding $5 million towards just over $10 million project. It would have been ERA funding that would have brought us from a technology readiness level of one, where only a concept has been proven, to a technology readiness level of nine, where the technology has now been fully commercialized.